strictly for the interest of this workshop, that when I saw the invitation, I extremely got excited. And I want to thank you, the conveners of this very, very important engagement. I also want to thank the participants. First of all, everybody has said you turned up in big numbers and in time. My invitation letter indicated 11. Then I thought Africa will keep in time. If I came in by 11:30 midday, I will still be in time. But when I got the turn up extremely excellent, then I know we have a great cause for all of us, that we really have one goal, but different fronts. And our goal, when all is said and done, is to ensure effective service delivery to the wananchi, and to ensure that the major call, His Excellency the President, has declared for this moment towards social economic transformation is met. Whether His Excellency the President or NRM government declares it all, this is an automatic call. And I would imagine it is a biblical call that everybody must actually be happy with the service delivery towards social economic transformation. And this is very, very important. How do we go towards this? Number one is what we are deliberating, and that has brought us here. Coordination. That effective coordination, effective communication equal to cooperation, call it collaboration. The two, if the other two are absent, then I swear we shall never cooperate, we shall never collaborate. And this is what is lacking in most of our institutions. We have a very big problem when it comes to coordination and when it comes to communication. People communicate in a trivial manner. People do whatever they want to do just for the sake of doing it. When it comes to an engagement like this, because it's one of the means of communication, this kind of meeting, some people come in as a mere tokenism. Let me just go for the sake of going. But not productively. That's why I'm very, very happy with you. Because even during that time, hands are still going up. Hands are still going up. It's only that the MC has decided to cut it short. But they have literally cut it whatever, whether biological or any other factor, and ensure that we are debating and we are making a discussion for the purposes of service delivery in Arua City, and therefore with life in general. So to me, I want to thank you for this extremely gentlemen. But as we noted in the presentation here, that all may come to a waste if we do not mitigate our climatic conditions. His Excellency the President has already given that executive order. By the time he gives the executive order, you know things are really going back. That we need to conserve our environment. If we are going to talk about development, and actually when we are talking about sustainable development, the kind of development that takes care of us now, but also will take care of our children, our unborn children, and the generations to come. So we need to really put in a lot of focus on this. And here I want to, in a special way, thank the NGOs, the development partners. Some of us call you implementing partners. You have played a significant role. When it comes to funding, government may not have, you saw when they were projecting the budget estimate here. The government may not have all this. we rely highly on you. Probably until we get our oil coming out, and when we make those changes. But for now, we cannot hide. You are doing a significant job, and we want to thank you for being here. We also want to note here, of course, that not only about funding, but your role on the more or less peer-to-peer development is too significant for us just to underestimate. Because you are NGOs, you are CPOs,